next thing I want to talk about is this here bicycle. But first,
okay, so it's been a while since I made a video, so I'm gonna do one now because why not? It'll be a bit of fun. Got a mountain bike, back out. Just do a bit of skirt and then take that out. Just go cruising for a little bit. So yeah, it'll be nice. Wildside on the back. Actually, while I think of it, I might take some happy snaps just for the light up here. Wildside merch. Well, not merch, just Wildside apparel. I'll put it on the screen, like right there. Okay. Next thing I want to talk about is this here bicycle. But first, I'm going to move over there, because there is way better light, so we'll just chuck a... Okay, it's not much better. Try one more time. Okay, this lighting is much. So, pretty much, this bike, the Polygon 50D6, I bought it about this time last year. It's a 2020 model, and I don't think they changed anything for 2021 other than the colours.
It was a great bike, especially when I was starting. I'm not finding it so great anymore. It was good when I was starting, because it's obviously an entry level bike. There's not that much of great stuff on it. The shock's fine, the fork is terrible, the brakes are good. I've still had this problem with the cassette. Keep taking it to get fixed, but nothing's changing. But yeah, it was good when I was starting because I was not great, but with the bike, I progressed really quickly once I had it, and then I sort of outgrew it. And now, every time I take it up to actual ride downhill trails and, you know, double blacks, that sort of thing, I usually break something. Or, you know, I have one stack and it's game over for the bike. That might just be like a wide error and I'm not being careful enough. But I've been having a lot of problems with the front wheel even after I got the rim replaced, so replaced the rim, but I'm still having the same problems, so I think it might be the fork that's creating the problems. Yeah, I've been having cassette issues the whole time and it's still just the stock cassette, so I might replace that and see what happens there. And the Suntour forks are not great. So I can't speak for all Polygon bikes, but as far as this one goes, I wouldn't recommend buying it. Like, even right now, I'm trying to figure out what my other options are if I were to buy a different bike soon.
As far as this bike goes, I'm gonna have to say, don't do it. I think generally, Polygon makes lower budget bikes. So, I mean, it's good if you're a beginner, but progress really quickly from a beginner, and I sort of outgrew the capabilities of this bike, and I just keep breaking it just from doing regular riding and tricks and stuff. As far as this Suntour fork goes, it's terrible. I mean, it is an air fork, which is great, so it's really adjustable. It's got the lockout, so that's cool too, but it's terrible. I found that when it gets cold, like on really cold days, it becomes really, really stiff. That's the truth about Polygon Siskiyou D6. Unfortunately. Like, the frame itself is great. I personally like it, I reckon it looks pretty cool, but all the components are just letting it down, for sure. If anyone sees this, they have anything to add or something they want to say, leave a comment or my Instagram. I'll leave a link in the description. If Polygon Bike sees this, unlikely, but if you do, get into contact with me. I definitely have some questions I want to ask about this bike and as well as all of your bikes.